In our high fives and smiles study, measuring smiles was an objective measure. That is, it's something that we can actually see and measure. However, we could have also asked the fellow Udassians to rate their level of happiness when I gave them a high five. In asking them to rate their happiness, we use a self-report measure, and this is a subjective measure. Now, I'm going to have Susan here give you a few more examples of different objective and subjective measures.
Another type of objective measure is a physiological response. Heart rate is one example of a physiological response. Sweating is another physiological measure. Physiological measures are also objective because we can quantify those responses. For the heart rate, we can use pulse to determine heart rate. Sweating, we can measure temperature, and we can also measure the galvanic skin response. One problem with self-report measures is that we can't be sure that they're completely accurate, but that is the only way we can get that information, is to ask the participant. Think back to Lauren's reaction to Tickles the Snake. We could use different psychological measures to assess her response. We can use an objective measure, meaning we could watch her run away. We could also look at her nervous laughter, and that would be an objective measure. We could also ask self-report. Hey, Lauren, how did you feel when you first saw that snake? A physiological objective measure, we could have measured her heart rate, which would have increased due to her fear response. We could have also measured her sweating. Most psychological experiments try to get both objective and subjective measures.